dive a little bit into your past. What was the moment that you realized that this is what you wanted to do for a job and that you can make a career out of it?
I guess when I got my first gig outside of Sweden, and I moved, I was a resident in a club in Stockholm called Spy Bar, and I was just playing there for fun, you know. I didn't know any other DJs, or it was, for me it was just like a fun thing. Developing into something, becoming a job, and I guess I started to get requests from other countries, and I was playing in Paris a little bit, and then I moved to Marbella for a residency in a club over the summer, and then from there I actually relocated to Ibiza. So I think in Ibiza something happened in me. I was there for a whole, like, from May until the end of the season, so I think that was probably, but I don't know, you know, I never had that moment. It's just something that really has been growing slowly, and I always thought, yeah, I'm gonna do something else, and also said the day when I have a family, when I have a child, I definitely have to do something else because I can't travel, you know, with kids. And then when I had a child, I was thinking maybe I can, you know, have a nanny, and maybe I can bring. And now it's actually my third one. I'm pregnant for the third time.
Congratulations.
Thank you. So it's, I don't know. It's just, you know, a lifestyle. It's hard to see it as a job or something. It's just like a way of living. And also the father of the children is doing the same thing. So it's just living it, I guess.
Well, do you remember the first record as a kid that you bought because you liked it so much?
Yeah, I do actually. My father's friend was—he had a record shop, and it was a Swedish group called Lili and Susie, and Roxette. I was buying music for them so very, very early. I guess I was like five or I don't know, very young. But it was big. Yep.
Roxette.
Roxette, yes.
Yeah, I know them.
Quite big in Holland too, or worldwide.
Very big in Holland.
Yeah.
All these incredible power ballads.
Yeah, I mean, Sweden is big with pop music in general, and it's a lot of producers. Sweden is a quite good music country, actually, for all kinds of music, from pop to techno, so it's...
Even you had a big hit also in Holland.
I'm sorry?
You had a big hit also in Holland.
Yes, I did. It was, actually, I think in Holland and Belgium, it was very...
Really top 40 hits.
Yes, crazy. Together with, like, Rihanna, and that was a big surprise, because I was never... you know, playing commercial music, and in the beginning I ended up in completely different settings than I was used to. You know, in Stockholm I was playing this small underground, dirty, you know, minimal club, and I was listening to, I don't know, I never expected it to be a commercial hit, but, you know, I don't regret anything, and it's led to so many, you know, things. And I think in the end, if you continue to do what you believe in, you end up in the right place eventually, and you have to start somewhere. And in Holland, I guess Disco Volante was a very commercial song, even though it was like not commercially intended to be. And it's no vocals or no. It's quite simple.
It's just a great vibe too.
It's a great, yeah. But in Belgium and Holland, it became in the charts together with other completely different music. It's interesting.
One of the key moments maybe in your career. And as you said, as long as it comes from the heart and it brings you to the next place, I mean, look where you are today.
Yeah, and you have to just follow your own path. I mean, I don't know how long my musical journey is going to be, but I you know, I hope I'm going to end up something completely different in the end. Like, you know, maybe make some other kind of music. I don't know. You know, I just see it as a life. I don't know, a whole way of living. So.